How's it going, guys? BB here with another episode of Life is Strange. We're jumping straight back in from last time, where we have gone all the way back in time when Chloe's father is still alive and Max is only 13. So let's just jump straight in.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here.
Joyce loves William so much.
I am, when your mom is away.
Let's have a look around.
Obvious, but it will have to do.
Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales.
What a mess we made.
What?
I remember those cool drawings I did with Chloe.
I know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
I have to stop William from taking his car today.
Ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Keys, please.
Let's see, where are his keys?
Oh yeah, I miss movie nights here. Cookies and popcorn.
Alright, so we found them. Let's just go all the way back.
Remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So how many eggs?
Let's see. I wanna
chef.
Right, like you're the real cook.
Put the drawing still back down here. Now where did his keys go? Where did he see them? I think they're in his jacket, right?
Sorry. Wrong number.
Max, come on, you know better than that. Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max.
Where was it?
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha.
I know they never took that big vacation.
Love you. Excuse me, ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful.
Chloe was so into manga. Nice hair.
Shit, where are my keys?
Where are the keys?
You mean your college fund? Keys, please.
Alright, I guess I'll just wait for it to go through and then we'll... That way we can see where he put them.
You'll be grateful for that someday.
Alright, so I need keys. To grab those.
You mean your college fund? Keys, please.
Hide the keys in there.
Shit, where are those keys?
Another dollar for the swear jar.
You're bankrupting me.
Oh, crap.
I knew this thing would come in handy. How did my keys get in here? And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session. What?
Let's see.
Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up.
Throw keys outside.
I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
Now, let's see if he finds them this time.
I know I had those keys right here. I know it.
Yeah, he can't hear it outside, so...
I forgot all about you, little buddy. Release the keys! Of course. Last time I ordered from Spy Guy Electronics.
You can take the bus, right? The stop is right down the street.
This I can do. Good call, Max.
Oh yeah, there we go. The bus is great. It comes every 15 minutes and there'll be plenty of room for you and Joyce and groceries and it'll save the environment.
You sold me already. I'm off to yonder bus stop. Joyce will love this.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
All right. Looks like that we saved her dad. Whole bunch of photos are changing. Well, that's a great photo. So, what does the future look like now?
I'm not paying $150 for a concert.
I heard that the Vortex Club parties are wild.
Dude, the service fee is like 50%.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
All my friends in LA told me that Oregon was
Max.
Gonna be wet and cold every day.
But never, like Maxine.
So that's why she was laughing so hard.
I know. Sorry, Mad Max. You're not pissed at me, right? Right?
No, it's people in Oregon.
Do you
want to
go hit the girls' potty and smoke a peace pipe?
I think Max is high.
She's acting like so weird. You cool, Max?
Nobody listened when I said we shouldn't let her in the vortex.
Courtney, you don't want anybody in the club.
Like, whatever, bitch.
So she's part of the vortex now.
Fine. He hooked up with Stella? Oh no! This is totally fucked up! What else have I changed? Chloe.
Yep, let's go and see what else is going on. He's a bus driver now. And yet another music set that is probably going to get this claimed. I really wish when it comes to games, especially indie games, they'll put out a version that is okay to put onto you. You don't get claimed to hell. Oh god, bunch of beached whales. That is never a good sign. Right, so let's see what's up with Chloe. There doesn't seem to be a truck's parked outside. The garden looks like it's being kept nice. And there is a wheelchair ramp.
Max Caulfield. Taking a break after taking Seattle by storm, huh? We thought we'd never see you again after you left for the big city.
No. I'd never do that to Chloe.
Speaking of, I know she's been dying to see you. Hold on. Chloe! You have a visitor!
Well, this is not what she was expecting, that's for sure. And it looks like we are on to the next part. The last episode of this game. Chaos Theory. Trophy earned. Alright, well, let's skip through here. Let's see how we did in this. 51% of people stole the money, which we didn't. I kissed Chloe, which is something that a lot of people did. sided with Chloe. 93% of people kept Frank's dog from harm. Let's see, Chloe has David's gun. Frank has David's gun. Okay. Reported Nathan. I confronted Victoria. You intervened to help out Kate, and you came out of hiding to intervene. Okay. So, yeah, we did all right, I guess.
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files.
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen. I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than a friend.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
A lot of shit has happened.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello? Are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield. Hold on.
You fucked up a lot.
You have a visitor.
And it looks like all of the apocalypse stuff is still going on. Okay, so now what, huh? Chloe's stuck in a wheelchair. Is there a way to turn that back? You know, I guess the sad thing is, to go back means that Chloe's dad is still dead. Or he can be alive and Chloe's stuck in a wheelchair. Kind of damned if you do, damned if you don't type of situation, isn't it? Life is Strange, Episode 4, Dark Room. Ooh, exciting. We're nearly finished, guys.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
Yeah, that
You're
kind
a real
of...
survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with... so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me.
I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Talk about the accident. Blame William. Talk about the accident.
Are you okay to talk about the accident? We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
You mean Rachel? What missing girl?
What missing girl?
I don't know her name. I just read about it in the news. I feel bad for her family.
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
It might be, you think? Don't say that.
It might be, but I'd like to think we can still change things for the better.
I'd like to think that too, but I don't have much hope these days.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. I was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
Well, really not the Chloe that we remember, that's for sure. Okay, so we're back at Chloe's place.
Pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe. You're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
So let's see.
Chloe's message board since the accident sure looks lonely. I didn't add much. Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun. Chloe is still a punk at heart. That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online. There's the old Chloe.
Let's see.
That must be her mighty morphine machine. No more bongs for her. Drink up, Buttercup.
Oh man, no wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember? You're right. Seems like yesterday.
To me, it seems like yesterday we were little brats here, watching Power Rangers and destroying the kitchen.
Oh my god. We covered everything in flour, even my parents.
That was so hilarious.
But a long time ago. You're the only person that I grew up with who visits me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Which friends? Or you have me? You have me.
You have me. I'm not leaving you, Chloe.
Well, you didn't visit me a lot either. I mean, I loved your cards and photos, but...
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Are you lonely? Are they okay? They love you.
I know this is a dumb question, but... Are you lonely here?
Yes, dumb question. I don't mind being alone. I can't exactly go party like a rock star, though. Or get in any teen trouble with the folks.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can they pay?
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Chloe, you're priceless. No pun intended.
You're such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
So sad.
Here's the DVD. Oh, the snow dough. I guess not everything changed. Snow globes are taking over.
So many snow globes.
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
Anything else interesting here to see?
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now. Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too. Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student. She could have gone to any college.
Yeah, she really was.
What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund. Even if it wasn't another reality.
Okay, let's put on a movie, eh?
That's a serious heat lamp. Oh my god, I made that mix for her when we were 12.
No, I wanted the DVD player. Go away. No, DVD player. There we go. Jeez. think they have to make a tough decision soon.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit.
Going through this one for the first time, I swear, I bawled my eyes out.
Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep this wag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Okay, so I've got to go upstairs.
Oh, great.
Yep, that's the same graffiti from before.
We have two messages from Victoria. Come by my room tonight. Max, are we cool? Just wanted to make sure since you walked away so fast. Nathan was worried too. If you want to talk, hit me up, okay? Love you. Max, if you're mad, just tell me, okay? Silence. So, if you want to talk, my door is open. Love you. So, it looks like that she is besties all of a sudden. Okie doke. So, upstairs, they said. So, what's in Chloe's room these days? Just an empty attic, it looks like. The height chart's still there?
I guess we stopped growing up together.
Let's see.
I never heard much about William's brother. Shoes. Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here.
You're not gonna let me open it? Okay.
They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again.
Well, that's sad.
Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation. A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence. At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
Looks like that's all to see in here. see, is there anything else we can be nosy at?
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around. Good morning, Max. Oh, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
I hope so.
You guys do such an amazing job taking care of her.
We can only do so much, and she gets damn sick of her parents. That's why it's so important you came to spend time with her. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family. And we'll always be one. No matter
what. So sad.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie. It's difficult. But nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
A lot of work. Eco Havoc. David Madsen?
Do you know somebody named David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Wheels.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
A lot of work.
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay. Stay away from his son, Nathan.
Eco Havoc.
What do you think is going on here with all of this eco havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
What about William?
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I, lucky to have him.
William's still the same. Chloe and William.
Chloe and William seem like they still get along so good.
Yeah, those two are closer now more than ever. Chloe will actually listen to William while she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit, things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
Alright, I guess we better go and get Chloe's morphine. Can I turn the light in here, or... Yep, switch that on. That's better.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend.
No.
The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
Anything else that's interesting in here?
Nothing here. It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine too.
Alright, we have it, so let's go back downstairs.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before.
Yeah, I guess some things have to change, eh?
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
Care room.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. The price is always right. Get it? No?
Yeah, well, sometimes you just have to do what you gotta do for family, eh?
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me? Glad you're here. Is she mad at me
for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Crazy weather, Rachel Amber, Prescott family. Crazy weather.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe
creepy,
and Joyce. My family.
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates.
Yeah, not the greatest. About Rachel Amber.
About that missing girl. Rachel Amber?
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
Yeah, well, that's the thing, isn't it? You know, I'm pretty sure we're going to have a bit of a choice whether to keep things this way or not.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise.
Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Alright, where is this photo album? Here we go. Let's sit down and reminisce about the old days.
Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my god, look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Hmm.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I'm assuming that's the photo that got them back in time. Yeah, it is.
Maybe I could...
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
Well, I hate to do it, but sorry. Nope.
Chloe. I can't. It wrecks me to see you in any pain, but I don't have any right to do this.
I'm an adult. I'm giving you the right.
But Joyce and William.
I already said my goodbyes to them, but they won't honor my wishes. You will, right?
I can't kill you with an overdose.
Max, I'm dying from my illness, not my dosage. This accelerates the process. I'd rather go out on a wave than a rock. And I want my best friend to help me out.
I am going to help you. But not like that. You have to believe me, Chloe.
Why, Max? You're just bailing on me like everybody else. Why don't you go now? You've been wanting to since you got here, right? So go and don't come back.
Chloe, I am never leaving you again.
Focus on the photo.
Sorry, William.
There we go. Now we'll go back in time one more time.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
This is so sad.
Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund? Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
That's kind of sad that she's burning that last photo. I mean, I get it, but still. Cake for dessert.
Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
But that's a pretty hard decision for anyone to have to do, eh?
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong, even if you feel like I wasn't there for you, because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back, always.
That's so sad. Can't help but get choked up about that. Now all of the pictures are changing back. Back to the photo of Chloe trying to stab the birthday cake. Like, I know that Chloe has had a hard life, but I'd much rather be in my life than like that. Oh, geez. And with that, I'm going to finish up this episode here because this has run reasonably long for this part. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button, and if you want to help out the channel and donate, you can do it a few different ways. You can go down to the description below and click my PayPal link for a one-off donation. You can become a member for 99 cents and you'll get your name on my end card of every single video. Or you can become a patron, and if you do, you'll get an awesome shout out just like Bernard, Linwood, Tracy, Chloe, SB Bear. They're all awesome bibliotheques and you can become one as well. So from Mai to Mecca, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hit that notification bell so then you can become an early bird on the channel and you won't miss out on any of my content. Subscribe for more videos like this and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.